我们请大家一起预备心，同心默祷。
Let's prepare our hearts and pray in silence.
阿门。奉主耶稣圣名，在我们诗歌崇拜之后，我们继续我们安息生日的正道聚会。
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we continue our Sabbath worship service.
一起来唱赞美诗129首。
Let's sing hymn 129.
Hallelujah, 我们亲爱弟兄姐妹大家平安。
Hallelujah, peace be with all the dear brothers and sisters.
路德记，我们知道它主要的内容是谈到以色列选民归回蒙福。
And the book of Ruth describes how the people of God return to God and to receive his blessings.
那以及预告非以色列人就是外邦人他们要领受神的救恩。
It was also a proclamation of how the Gentiles could come to God and receive salvation.
但是很多人借着路德记来谈在家庭里头尤其是婆媳之间的关系。
But many have also used the book of Ruth to find lessons in the relationship between mother-in-law and daughter-in-law.
那反而替代了这个路德记主要的主题。
And in some instances, that overshadows the spiritual theme of the book.
那其实路德记，他要讲的，不是婆媳之间的关系。
And in fact, the book of Ruth is not a book about in-law relationships.
而是神跟人之间的关系。
Rather, it teaches us about the relationship between God and people.
但是因为这个婆媳关系的问题，从古至今呢，都困扰着很多的家庭。
But yet, issues in the relationship between mother-in-law and daughter-in-law have existed throughout history.
很容易让人看到路德记就想到说在讲婆媳关系。
And so when we read the story of Ruth, that may be the first thing that comes to mind.
谈到婆媳关系，我们俗话说一山不容二虎不能容下两只母老虎了
So there is a saying that says that there can be not be too many chefs in the kitchen.
所以当一个家庭开始唱两只老虎的时候其他的成员就有得受了
And so if there are too many cooks, then the family will suffer.
有一对这个婆婆正在聊天。
There's a story that says the ghost that there's two mother-in-laws who are chatting.
那这个 A 就问 B 说，你的女儿好吗？
And so mother-in-law A says to B, how is your daughter?
说我的女儿，感谢神还不错。
And the reply was, thank God, my daughter is doing well.
她的丈夫对她很好。
Her husband treats her well.
甚至早上都准备好早餐端到他的床上给他吃
He would even get up early in the breakfast and make her breakfast and bring it to her bed.
那这个 A 又问说，问 B 说，那你的媳妇好吗？
And so then A asked again, how is your daughter-in-law good?
这个 B 就说，谈到我媳妇我媳妇实在不好。
And B responded, my daughter-in-law is no good.
可怜我的儿子
My son has it so tough.
每天都要准备好早餐端到床上给他吃。
He has to get up early in the morning and make her breakfast.
这个女婿跟儿子是不同的女儿跟媳妇也不一样。
And so clearly there is a distinction between sons and daughter-in-laws and daughters and sons.
同样一件事情却有不同的解读。
Even though the actions are the same, the interpretations are different.
那个 B 就问反问 A 了。So now, 那你呢？
Mother B asked Mother A,
你的媳妇好吗？
How is your daughter-in-law?
我的媳妇要怎么说大致上还不错了，就是有一点底漏。底漏这个意思就是说经常会把这个家里的东西带回娘家去，这个叫底漏了。
And so the mother-in-law replied that she is okay, but often she would take her things from her family back to her own family, back from her family back to her own mother.
哦，那这个啊，好、哦，这个 B 就说啊，那还得了啊？哦啊，这个家产再多啊，哦，也会被他扒光的啊。
So mother-in-law B responded, "How can she do that? She would be removing all of your properties and back to her own house."
哦，那这个 A 说，好在啊，我的女儿啊，也经常从她夫家拿东西回来孝敬我。
And mother-in-law A replied, "But good thing that my own daughter would take stuff from her own house and bring them back to me."
哦。同样的事情，不同的解读哦。
Again, same actions, different interpretations.
哦，一个就变成坏媳妇，一个变成孝顺的好女儿。
And so one would be good, and the other bad.
哦，所以这个婆媳之间的问题，哎，说真的哈、哦，这个也是古今中外啊，哦，很多家庭的困扰。
And regardless of time and culture, issues between mothers-in-laws and daughters-in-laws have always been there.
哦，但是我们从路德记。却看到、哦、一对模范的婆媳。
But in the book of Ruth, we find a model mother-in-law and daughter-in-law.、
哦、在路德记我们看到的都是正面的人物，没有负面的。
And in the book of Ruth, we see many positive examples.、
哦、那尤其是这个拿俄米这个婆婆、哦、跟媳妇路德他们之间相处的、哦、可以说、啊、是哦，这个是个模范。
And when we study the interaction between the mother-in-law Naomi and the daughter-in-law Ruth, there's many things we can learn from.
哦，做人媳妇的都希望说，我的婆婆如果能像拿俄米有多好啊。
Many wives would wish that their mother-in-laws were like Naomi.
哦，那当婆婆的也会想说啊，我的媳妇如果像路德这样有多好啊。
Many mothers wish that their daughter-in-law would be like Ruth.
哦，那我们就来看看哦，啊，是什么原因？哦，让这一对婆媳啊能够相处得非常好，哦，情同母女一样。
So let us study the book to see what was the reason why they would live together as if they were mothers and daughter.
哦，我们从路德记哦这个四章当中读了下来，我们发现哦能够让哦路德跟拿俄米能够拥有和谐的婆媳关系，主要的原因呢、啊？在于他们有共同的信仰。
And when we read through the four chapters in the book, we find that they were able to live as mother and daughter because they have a common faith.
我们知道、哦、这个拿俄米、跟着他的先生离开自己的本族本家、啊、搬到摩押地去了。
Naomi had went with her husband and left her own homeland to the land of Moab.、
哦、离开了神的家，最后落得啊哦，成为啊，哦，这个丧失所有、啊，连先生儿子都死掉。
And when they departed from the house of God, she lost everything, her husband and her sons.
哦，只剩下啊三个寡妇面对三座坟墓。
And what was left were three widows.
哦，那这个时候，哦，拿俄米哦要他两个媳妇啊各回自己的哦娘家去啊，另外啊哦再改嫁。
In the beginning of the story, we find Naomi asking her daughter-in-laws to return to their homeland to remarry.
哦，因为她再也没有儿子啊，可以哦，可以给他们，或者是啊，哦，她也没办法再生儿子哦，来给他们当丈夫啊。
Because she had no other sons for them to be husbands to them, and she was too old to bear any more children.
哦，大好、哦、这个大媳妇回去了，哦，但是这个路德啊，却哦啊一直要跟着哦这个拿俄米这位婆婆。
So the wife of the elder son returned to her homeland, but the wife of the younger son, Ruth, clung to her mother-in-law.
啊、哦、那这个路德。哦，她原本并不是以色列人，她是摩押的女子。
Ruth was not an Israelite; she was a Moabite.
哦，换句话说，哦，这个拿俄米啊的儿子啊，哦，是娶的哦非以色列人哦，那这个啊的女子啊做太太的。
And both sons of Naomi married Moabites as wives.
哦，不同的民族拥有着不同的信仰。
Because of their ethnic background, they had a different religious background.
哦，但是当拿俄米决意要回到 这个伯利恒他原本的出生之地。
But when Naomi decided to return to her birthplace in Bethlehem,
这个不离开婆婆舍不得婆婆的这个路德也亦步亦趋的跟着回来。
Ruth, who clung to her mother-in-law, was determined to go with her.
这个意味着路德她必须要做一些改变。
And this means that Ruth had to make changes in her life.
她要做什么改变呢？
What kind of changes?
我们来看路德记的第一章。
Let's read Ruth chapter 1.
我们来看十五节。
Ruth chapter 1 verse 15.
一章十五节，拿俄米说，看啊，你嫂子已经回她本国和她所拜的神那里去了，你也跟着你嫂子回去吧。十六节。
16.
路德说：“不要催我回去，不跟随你。你往哪里去，我也往哪里去；你在哪里住宿，我也在哪里那里住宿。你的国就是我的国，你的神就是我的神。”十七节。
17.
你在哪里死，我也在。哪里死也葬在那里，除非死能使你我相离，不然愿神重重的降罚于我。十八节。
18.
拿阿米见路德定义要跟随自己，就不再劝他了。十九节。
19.
于是二人同行来到伯利恒。我们读到这里这里谈到说，当这个路德定义要跟随拿阿米，
Ruth was determined to follow Naomi.
她对她的婆婆拿俄米说出了这样的话。
And these were her words.
说你往哪里去，我就往哪里去；你在哪里住，我就在哪里住。
Wherever you go, I will go. Wherever you lodge, I will lodge.
除非死才能够让我们相离。
Unless only death can part you and me.
所以最后就是二人同行了。
And in the end, the Bible says the two of them went together.
我们看到路德他做出如此大的一个改变。
Ruth made a life-changing decision.
其实他如果听他婆婆的话回去自己的这个地方去生活比较容易。
It was probably easier for her to return to her homeland and to find a better life.
同样的生活习惯嘛。
Because she would live as she was, as she had before.
对这个路德来讲并不需要做任何改变。
She would not need to make drastic changes.
但是她如果坚决地要跟随着这个拿俄米回到这个以色列地区。
But if she was determined to go with Naomi to Israel,
她的生活就必须要做调整跟改变。
She has to change the way she lived.
她要去适应一个全新的生活。
She has to adjust to a brand new life.
去适应一个以前没有这个去过的环境。
She had to go to a place where she's never been.
很多时候我们看姐妹嫁到这个夫家去
And when many sisters, when they get married,
我们经常想到说这个婚姻嘛，就是这个夫妻两个才是主角。
We think that a marriage involves two parties, the husband and wife.
但是很少会去想到说，其实对这个姐妹来说，她必须要去适应一个完全不同于自己成长背景的环境。
But to many newlywed wife, it's the wife who I have to adjust to a new environment.
所以不单是夫妻两方面的事情。
So marriage is not just a matter of two people.
这个不同的环境所带来不同的冲击跟压力，也会让这个做太太、做媳妇的面临很大的挑战。
But we also have to consider the challenges faced by the wife, the daughter-in-law, when she,in a new environment.
尤其这个婆媳之间的关系
Especially in her relationship with the mother-in-law.
往往不会亚于这个夫妻之间的冲突。
And the conflict is maybe just as serious as the conflict between husband and wife.
所以对这个做媳妇来讲她必须要面对她必须要做出一个很大的改变。
So a daughter-in-law often has to make big changes.
如果她不愿意改变，
If she is unwilling to change,
她还是要保留在自己原本的 这个原生的家庭那种生活的模式。
If she wants to live as the same way she had lived in her own house.
哦，或者是保留自己成长背景熟悉的这个生活模式。
If she want to keep all her the habits and everything she's done in the past.
那势必就会有很大的这个适应上的问题。
Then it would be difficult to for her to adjust.
哦，在生活上就有很多的这个摩擦会产生。
And conflicts would arise in her life.
哦，所以路德他必须改变他自己。
And so Ruth had to change herself.
去适应一个新的环境，新的家庭。
To adjust to a new environment and a new family.
一个全新的生活模式。
And a new way of life.
所以他必须要调整他自己跟她婆婆一样。
So she had to be change herself to be more like her mother-in-law.
所以这里说两人同行。
And the two of them went.
怎么能同行？
How would they go together?
如果之前没有调整自己的心态，成为两人同心，又怎么能够两人同行？
If she had not adjust her attitude, then how could she have gone together with her mother-in-law?
所以这里路德跟她婆婆说说你往哪里去，我就往哪里去的。
Ruth said, "Wherever you go, I will go."
我没有我自己的想法跟意见。
And she did not hold on to her own ideas.
你在哪里住宿，我就在哪里住宿。
Wherever you lodge, I will lodge.
你要在哪里落脚，我就在哪里落脚
了。Where you want to live, I will live.
所以路德调整他自己。能够跟她婆婆同心。
So Ruth changed herself so that she could be of one heart with her mother-in-law.
好，那到底是什么力量能够让路德做这么大的一个改变？
And how was Ruth able to make such a big change?
路德又跟她婆婆说说你的国就是我的国，你的神就是我的神。
She said further, "Your people shall be my people, your God my God."
这里我们看出让路德能够调整她的心态去适应她婆婆要带她去的这个新的环境，主要是在她信仰上面要做改变。
And so Ruth was able to make a life change because she had changed, made a big change in her faith.
信仰是超越国际、超越种族的。
And faith is bigger than culture and nations.
它是道德是非观、价值人生观的一个综合。
It encompasses all morality and what is good.
所以如果在信仰上能够一致的话。
If there is one faith,
在很多生活上、观念上、态度上就容易能够一致。
Then it would be easier to become one with in our thoughts and in our mind.
在现今这个交通发达已经成为全球化地球村的时候
And today we have many advanced technologies and communications.
跨国跨种族的婚姻比比皆是。
And it is, interracial marriages are becoming more and more common.
那要怎么样找出能够彼此互相适应，能够同心同行的这个婚姻生活来
？Then in our life of marriage, how are we able to live as one and be of one heart and mind?
信仰。将会提供我们一个很大的帮助
And our faith is the way to help our marriage.
谈到说不同种族，我们就想到说语言的问题
And one if in an interracial marriage, one common issue might be language.
小弟跟小弟的内人，虽然都是在台湾出生的
，Even though my both my wife and I were born in Taiwan.
但是我们却来自于。不同的 家庭的这个背景。
But we come from very different families.
小弟是土生土长的这个在可以说是台湾人啊。
My family has been in Taiwan for many generations.
我很自然讲的就是台湾的方言这个闽南语。
So my first language is Taiwanese.
那我的太太是也虽然也是在台湾出生。但是我岳父是在49年跟着国民党政府到台湾的。
And my wife, although she was born in Taiwan, her father was a relatively recent immigrant from mainland China.
那因为是这个军公教人员哦，所以原本他们生住的地方啊，就是政府所安排的这个眷村。
And because he was in the military, they had lived in a government-assigned housing.
哦，讲的啊，最主要是哦，这个普通话哦，就是国语。
And her first language was Mandarin.
哦，那我太太是直到来我们正耶稣教会哦，才开始接触台语。
And my wife did not know Taiwanese until she came to the True Jesus Church.
哦，她还曾经告诉我说，有一次啊。人家问他说：“你听得懂台语吗？”他说他懂。
And she even told me once that someone asked her, "Do you understand Taiwanese?" And she replied, "Yes."
啊，所以人家就问他说：“那打鸡打瓜是什么意思啊？”
And so they asked her, "What do you know what this word or that word means?"
哎，这个打鸡打瓜的意思就是公公婆婆了。
And they said mother-in-law and father-in-law in Taiwanese.
哦，但是我太太却回答说：“豆腐跟豆干呢？”
But she had no idea what they were saying.
Oh, hey, so, 不同的种族，哈，啊，就是，哦，啊，语言都不一样，更不要谈说不同国家了，哦。
So even in the same culture, you might have different dialects and backgrounds and issues with communication. Not to mention different races.
哎，说这个，这个一个留学生哦，在美国成家立业，哈。那带着他的儿子回台湾去呀，看他的爸爸妈妈。
There's a student who studied abroad and had raised a family, and he went back, he returned to his homeland with his family to visit.
哦，那个爸爸就交代他的儿子说，哦，要有礼貌，看到长辈要问安哦。
So the father said to his son, "You have to be polite and greet people."
哦，啊，结果回台湾的隔天呐。就看到自己爸爸坐在客厅在生闷气。
But the next morning, he saw his own father, angry in the living room.
哦，因为他们是这个乡下是啊在种田的这个家庭。
And so he grew up in the countryside.
哦，那也很传统。
And so his family was quite traditional.
儿子是看到爸爸生气，就说啊，爸爸你在生什么气
？So this young father asked his father, "Why are you mad?"
哦，他说啊，这个你的儿子，哦。这么没礼貌。
And his father said, "Your son is so rude."
哦，那这个儿子就说啊，哦，那怎么样啊
？And so he asked, "What happened?"
哦，那你的儿子啊，一大早看到我就跟我讲说啊，牛不拎啊，啊，说我们家那个牛没有奶啊。
这怎么办？
那他 so, 那儿子就说不是啊，那个是在向你问早安 ，Good morning 啊。
So he said that your son said that our cow have no milk, which but his son was actually saying good morning in English to his grandfather, but that sounded like your cow has no milk.
哦，爸爸说乱讲，他要出门之前呢，还回我一句说 goodbye。说我的牛不好，所以没有奶。
And then the grandfather further complained that when your son left, he said that our cow is bad because he said goodbye in English, which sounded like your cow is bad in Taiwanese.
儿子说啊，爸爸，那个是在说再见呐。
So the son said, "Well, that is he was saying goodbye in English."
哦，所以我们想，可以想象得到哦，啊，无论是这个不同种族或者是不同国家。哦，在生活在一起啊，哦，会有很多的这个笑话也好，摩擦也好啊。
So when different cultures and different backgrounds come together, you might have funny stories, but you might also have conflicts.
哦，那这个时候如果我们有共同的信仰
，But if we have a common faith,
哦，因为信仰的帮助啊，让我们哦能够有一致的道德是非观。哦，价值人生观。
And with a common faith, we have a common standard and common values.
哦，这也是为什么我们经常会勉励我们主内的弟兄姐妹在择偶或者是为我们儿女在选对象的时候要以我们同样信仰来做考虑。
And that is why when we encourage our young members to finding a suitable spouse, and they need to consider faith.
哦，我们来看一下这个 一个婆婆的心声。
Let's take a look at a mother-in-law.
我们请看创世纪的二十六章。
Genesis 26.
创世纪二十六章，我们请看三十四节。
Genesis 26 verse 34.
三十四节，以扫四十岁的时候，娶了赫人比利的女儿犹低啊，与赫人以伦的女儿巴什抹为妻。三十五节
，35.
他们常使以撒和利百加心里愁烦。我们再跳过来看二十七章
，and let's read chapter 27.
二十七章，请看四十六节。
27 verse 46。
四十六节，利百加对以撒说：“我因这赫人的女子，连性命都厌烦了。倘若雅各也娶赫人的女子为妻，像这些一样，我活着还有什么益处呢？”你看到这个婆媳关系紧张到说连活着都没有意义了。
And you can see that the relationship between the mother-in-law and daughter-in-law here has deteriorated to the point that Rebecca was tired of her life.
所以最主要的原因呢，就是没有共同的信仰，导致也没有这个一致的这个价值观、人生观、道德观、是非观。
And the big reason is that she had a different faith and therefore different values, different morals, a different way of life.
所以路德跟拿俄米这一对模范的婆媳能够相处的这么融洽，最主要归根究底的原因就是他们有个共同的信仰。
And Ruth and Naomi were able to live in harmony primarily because they had the same faith.
路德他做了改变。
Because Ruth chose to change.
他以他婆婆的神这个独一的真神为她的神。
She would have the God of Naomi as her own God.
所以能够让她跟她婆婆能够有共同的这个生活。
And therefore she is able to live the same life as her mother-in-law.
能够同心，能够同行。
So that they could have the same heart and walk together.
那这个同心跟同行表现在他们的生活里头。
So they showed how they have the same heart in her life.
我们也可以从路德记里头看出。
We can learn from the book of Ruth.
第一个
，First，
他们能够彼此互相尊重。
And they were able to respect each other.
我们看路德记的第二章。
Let's turn to Ruth chapter 2.
二章我们请看第二节。
Ruth chapter 2 verse 2.
二章二节，摩押女子路德对拿俄米说：“容我往田间去，我蒙谁的恩，就在谁的身后拾取麦穗。”拿俄米说：“女儿啊，你只管去。”在这里我们看到，这个拿俄米跟路德他们的关系非常的融洽，彼此互相的尊重。
From this verse, we could tell that Ruth and Naomi respected each other.
路德跟婆婆讲说容我去捡麦穗。
Ruth said to Naomi, "Please let me go to the field to glean heads of grain."
捡麦穗才能够让生活能够过得下去。
She had to go to the field to collect food for them.
当时以色列人这个神的律法有吩咐他们必须要照顾孤儿跟寡妇跟寄居的人。
This was part of God's law for the people to take care of the widows and the orphans.
所以路德跟拿俄米回到自己的这以色列地刚好他们是大概收割麦这麦子的时候。
So when after Naomi and Ruth return, there was time that during the time of harvest.
那根据律法的规定他们必须要让穷人，让这个孤儿跟寡妇跟在后面拾取他们收割掉下来这个麦穗。
And so it was in God's law that these the landowners must allow the widows to follow the workers and to collect the grain that fall as they harvest the grain.
这个时候这个当媳妇的路德他就负起这样的一个生活的这个责任了。
And so Ruth took up the responsibility to take care of their livelihood.
但是她还是要请求她婆婆的允准。
But still she asked for permission from her mother-in-law.
容我去吧。
Please let me go.
哦，而不是说啊，我如果不去捡呐、啊，婆婆你吃什么啊？啊
，She didn't say
石头都没有。
If I don't go, what are we going to eat?
啊、哦，但是她还是请示她的婆婆。
She still asked.
哦，尊重她的婆婆。
Because she respected her mother-in-law.
好、哦，那看这个婆婆啊，哦，她怎么回答路德
？And how did Naomi, the mother-in-law, reply?
哦，你只管去呀、啊，女儿。
Go, my daughter.
哦，所以我们看到哦，这一对哦，这个婆媳啊，就好像母女一样。
And so this was a conversation between a mother and a daughter.
他们是相互尊重的。
They respected one another.
哦。这个我们先看哦，这个路德哈、哦，他哦，这个做媳妇的一些哈、哦、一些好的特质啊。
So let us study some of the characteristics of Ruth as a daughter-in-law.
哦，首先我们看到她有孝心。
And so she honored her mother-in-law.
哦，她是主动啊，哦。要负起奉养婆婆的责任。
She took the initiative to take care of her mother-in-law.
哦，这个是哦，这件事情啊，哦，也让周围的人呐、啊、都非常的敬佩。
And the people around her noticed and respected her for it.
哦，这路德记的二章的十一节。
Let's read Ruth chapter 2:11.
哦，这个拿俄米的至亲哈、哦，财主波阿斯啊，哦。对路德这么说、啊、
And these are the words of their close relative Boaz.
哦，十一节，波阿斯回答说啊，自从你丈夫死后，凡你向婆婆所行的，并你离开父母和本地，到素不相识的民中，这些事人全都告诉了我。哦，哎，我们看哦，这个路德的好行为，他的孝心啊，哦，可以说啊，邻里皆知啊。
So Ruth's good deeds was known by the people around her.
哦，这就是路德哦，他啊、这个哦，就当人媳妇的一个好的特质。
And that's the good characteristics of Ruth.
哦，说实在哦，当媳妇不容易啊。
It is difficult to be a daughter-in-law.
哦，刚刚哦谈到这个哦闽南语哈、哦，我就想起小时候听过的一首。闽南语的歌叫做阿嬷的话哈，奶奶的话。
And there is, I remember a nursery rhyme from my youth, called my grandma's words.
哦，说做人媳妇要知道道理，晚晚睡觉要早早起。
And so it is about the demands of a mother-in-law to the daughter-in-law that you have to go to bed late and wake up early in the morning.
哎，啊，烦恼哈、哦，啊，天不会亮，啊，烦恼啊，鸭子没有蛋。
You have to worry that there is no light. You have to worry that there are no eggs.
哦，烦恼啊，这个小姑要嫁没嫁妆，啊、烦恼小叔要娶没有床。
You have to worry that your brother-in-law and sister-in-law do not have enough to be married.
哦，当然这个哈、哦、是写的比较夸张一点哦。
And this might be an exaggeration.
哦，但是告诉说做人家媳妇的哈、哦。要知道道理的第一项就是主动。
But it's a reminder that as in-laws we must take the initiative.
哦，主动在家里哦，这个帮忙哦啊，在家里呀 啊，负起责任来。
We have to take responsibility in the house.
哦，尤其啊，对于奉养哦这个公婆的事情。
And especially when it comes to taking care of the father-in-law and the mother-in-law.
我们看到并不是婆婆要求路德，而是路德主动要做。
And Naomi did not ask Ruth to do anything, but Ruth took action.
哦，那路德要去做的、啊、哦，不是啊，哦，这个打扮得漂漂亮亮在外面哦。而是、啊、去做十麦穗的这个粗重的苦工啊。
And what Ruth had to do was not glamorous. She had to go to the field to glean the heads of grain.
哦，这个是卑微的。哦，这个是啊，哦，这个人家不愿意做的。
It was a lowly task that people didn't really want to do.
但是路德他肯谦卑的去拾取麦穗。
But Ruth humbled herself to do it.
哦，拾麦穗啊，你要弯腰拾啊。
She had to.Be bent over to glean the grains from the field.
你没有弯腰谦卑啊，你就捡不到了。
And if we are not humble to be able to be willing to bend, she would not have gotten anything.
哦，我想路德啊，弯腰谦卑是从家里对她婆婆 从心里头做起的。
And she was able to humble herself because from her heart she wanted to take care of her mother-in-law.
所以在生活上，在这个拾取麦穗上，她也能够承担得起。
So she would do whatever it takes to take care of her.
再来，路德她体恤她的婆婆。
And Ruth was also considerate of her mother-in-law.
我们看，我们来看路德记的第三章啊。
Let's turn to Ruth chapter 3.
三章第十节。
Ruth chapter 3 verse 10.
十节波阿斯说啊，女儿啊，愿你蒙神赐福，你末后的恩比先前更大，因为少年人无论贫富，你都没有跟从。在这里我们看到这个波阿斯称赞路德。
And here, Boaz commended Ruth.
除了她孝顺她的婆婆之外，
not only was did she honor her mother-in-law.
这个路德啊，她并且她能够体恤她的婆婆已经有年纪了。
And Ruth was also considerate that her mother-in-law is advanced in age.
她其实路德还年轻，她还可以改嫁。
Ruth was still young, and she could marry. She had a chance of remarriage.
但是她却舍放不下她这个年迈的婆婆。
But she would not leave her mother-in-law behind.
对啊，我如果改嫁，那我婆婆怎么办
？If she married into marry someone else, what would happen to her mother-in-law?
谁来奉养她
？Who would take care of her?
所以我们看到路德，她当人媳妇，一个。我们看出了一个特质来啊，就是他有孝心，他有谦卑的心，还有他有体恤人的心呢。
So Ruth was respectful, and she was considerate.
所以她主动去拾取麦穗，而不是婆婆要她去。
And so she took the initiative to glean the grains from the field.
她愿意谦卑来做这个粗重的。这个粗活啊。
She humbled herself to do a lowly task.
她体恤婆婆，一个人孤苦伶仃，没有依靠。
And she was considered that her old mother-in-law needed to be taken care of.
所以三章的五节说凡婆婆所讲的事情路德都照做。
So chapter 3 verse 5 it says that she would do whatever her mother-in-law says.
我想不要说做人的媳妇，做人的儿女能够做到这样子，也真的不容易。
And not to mention daughter-in-law, it is hard for even a son or daughter to do this.
这个就是我们从这个路德，他怎么样做一个媳妇，我们看出一个好媳妇的特质来。
So, these are the good characteristics of Ruth as a daughter-in-law.
那我们也可以从这个他们彼此的尊重关怀，也可以看出，从拿俄米身上看出一个做好婆婆的特质。
And on the other hand, we could also learn from Naomi her characteristics as a mother-in-law.
其实拿俄米在还没有回到自己的本族本家，就已经考虑到这两个媳妇的将来。
Even before she returned to her home, she consider the future of her two daughters-in-law.
要他们回自己的娘家去啊。另外为自己的将来幸福打算。
That's why she has said to them to go back to their homeland to secure their future.
那当这个路德跟着他回来啊。
When Ruth returned with Naomi.
这个拿俄米啊，他甚至要为路德来找一个。这个归宿啊。
Naomi took action to find someone for Ruth.
我们看三章的第一节。
Let's read Ruth chapter 3 verse 1.
三章一节，路德的婆婆拿俄米对她说：“女儿啊，我不当为你找个安身之处，使你享福吗？”我们看到这个当婆婆的并不把这个媳妇当成好像她私有的财产，或者是她的女佣。这个下人供他的驱使呼唤。
And Naomi did not treat Ruth as her servant or her property.
她是把她当成 好像自己的骨肉、自己的女儿一样来看待。
Ruth was like her own daughter.
天下父母心呐、啊，哪一个父母啊不希望说自己的儿女能够得着幸福
？And every parent wants their children to live a good life.
所以我们看到这个当婆婆的拿俄米，她不自私。
So Naomi, as a mother-in-law, was not selfish.
她用爱来对待这个媳妇路德。
And she loved her daughter-in-law.
这个是很难得哈。
And this is not common.
对，很多这个。婆媳有问题的家庭来说、
啊、When there's problems between mother-in-law and daughter-in-law.
大都是出在说，这个当婆婆的始终没有办法接纳这个媳妇啊，像自己这个女儿一样。
Very often it is because the mother-in-law cannot accept the daughter-in-law as her own daughter.
总是觉得说她是外人。
She still considers the daughter-in-law as someone from the outside.
所以有些时候啊，跟自己的这个小孩哈，跟儿子哈，跟自己的女儿讲一些事情，不让媳妇知道的。
So she would say things to her own daughter or son and hide things from the daughter-in-law or son-in-law.
其实这是不对的
But that is not right.
人家把女儿托付给你的儿子进到你的家。
And someone has married their daughter into your house.
就是希望你能够像自己所亲生的女儿一样来对待、来疼爱。
And it is right to treat her as your own daughter.
想一想人家平白无故啊，帮你养养一个女儿、啊。养了二三十年了、啊，才还给你哦。
Someone has raised this woman for 20, 30 years, and now she is part of your house.
那你不接纳，你把她当外人。
And if you do not accept her and still think that she's an outsider.
这样对吗
？And is that right?
实在是说不过去。
There's no reason for that.
所以拿俄米，我们看到这个好婆婆第一个特质。就是用爱接纳这个路德。
So the first characteristic of Ruth is that she treated her daughter-in-law as her own.
什么是爱
？What is love？
爱就是不自私。
Love is not selfish.
不是单爱自己。
Love does not love oneself only.
路德没有想说我是个寡妇，所以你也要当一辈子寡妇。
Naomi did not think that I am a widow, so you must be a be a widow with me all your life.
而是她能够用这个做母亲的嫁女儿的心肠希望她的媳妇能够得到更好的生活。
But she acted like a mother who wanted her daughter to marry someone good.
那第二个，我们看到这个拿俄米好婆婆的特质，在于她愿意教导。
The second characteristic of Ruth, of Naomi as a mother-in-law, is that she was willing to guide and teach.
第二章的二十二节
，Chapter two，
三章的三到四节
，Verse 22 and Chapter 3 verses 3 and 4。
我们看到这个婆婆教导路德
，And Naomi as a mother-in-law taught Ruth。
怎么样拾取麦穗待在这个波阿斯的田里头，不要到其他的人。
She taught Ruth that to stay in the field of Boaz.
教导路德啊，照着律法向波阿斯来提起代赎的义务。
And she taught Ruth how to do according to the law, so that Boaz would take the responsibility to take care of them according to the law.
有时候这个当婆婆的会有那种媳妇熬成婆的那种心态。我好不容易啊，从人家的媳妇现在变婆婆了所以我也把以前我婆婆怎么对我，我也拿来对我的媳妇了。
And many mother-in-laws may treat their daughter-in-law as a way of payback because they had suffered as daughters-in-law before.
所以经常会说我们以前怎么样怎么样哪像你们现在的人。
You may hear mother-in-law say, "I used to do this and that, not like you."
有一对夫妻这个他的，这个等于说，婆婆要来呀、所以这个做媳妇的好紧张，一个礼拜前就把家里尤其厨房打扫得一尘不染哦。
So once a mother-in-law who was going to visit a young couple, and this daughter-in-law took all week to clean up her house.
因为她知道这个婆婆有洁癖。
Because she knew that her mother-in-law had was very clean.
哦，婆婆那一天来还带着女儿哈一起来。
The mother-in-law even brought her own daughter to visit.
哦，二话不说都到厨房去了。
The first thing she did was to go to the kitchen.
这边摸摸，那边擦一擦。
She touched here and there.
哦，然后啊，当着哦媳妇的面前呐、啊，跟自己的女儿说。
So in front of her daughter-in-law, she said to her own daughter,
我讲的没有错吧
？Didn't I tell you?
哦。他们呐、啊、懒得开火，你看厨房这么干净。
They're so lazy. I bet they don't ever cook in this kitchen.
哦，做媳妇我没有当场昏倒。
What would you have done as a daughter?
哦，花了一个礼拜才打扫干净啊。哦，结果婆婆说，懒惰不煮饭。
If she has spent all week cleaning, and yet the response was that you're too lazy, you never use the kitchen.
哦，所以有时候这个婆婆的关怀啊，是用这个挑毛病挑剔。来关怀媳妇。
So many mother-in-law show their concern by picking out problems,
而不是真正哈啊、这个啊、像这个路德一样啊啊，为了这个媳妇的好处将来来打算。
Instead of showing true concern as Naomi did for Ruth's future.
哦，所以我们看到这一对夫哦，这一对这个啊婆媳啊，能够相处的融洽，在于他们能够彼此尊重、彼此信赖。彼此关怀。
So this mother-in-law and the daughter-in-law lived in harmony because they were considerate to each other and relied on each other.
哦，其实啊，每一位婆婆都曾经是人家的媳妇啊。
And many, oh, the mother-in-law used to be a daughter-in-law.
而每一位媳妇将来都会成为人家的婆婆。
And every daughter-in-law will become a mother-in-law.
哦，那势必啊，我们要怎么样扮演？好，我们媳妇的角色跟婆婆的角色。
And how do we play well the roles that we have?
好，去形成一个对整个家庭一个好的循环的帮助。
So that it becomes a good cycle and to help our own families.
而不是一种坏的循环。
And not a vicious cycle.
好，那因着这个拿俄米跟路德他们彼此尊重、彼此信赖、彼此关怀。
And because Naomi and Ruth had a mutual respect and mutual concern and care.
哦，他们也得到好处啊。
They received gain.
他们得到什么好处
？What did they gain?
哦，他们把哦那个拿俄米啊，把他先生的产业哈、哦、赎了回来。
And Naomi was able to redeem the property of her husband.
哦，而且啊啊、哦，让了先生呐、啊，哦，有了后代哈、哦，可以啊。这个存名下去。
And she gained, she was able to gain descendants, and so to, continue the family line.
因为照律法的规定，哈，啊，这个路德，哦，嫁给波阿斯，哦，第一个孩子，哈，要归路德的前夫啊。
According to the law, the first son of Ruth by Boaz would belong to the house of Naomi's husband.
哦，那个财产呢要。哦，归在他这个这前夫这个哦这个啊儿子的名下。
And the property would be passed on to her first son.
哦，如果没有路德
if Ruth was not there,
拿俄米凭他自己办得到吗
？Naomi would not be able to do anything about it.、哦、
不要说她年纪大哈、哦，嫁不出去哈、哦。那老太太哦，就算有人要，也生不出小孩来的哈。
Not to mention that no one would marry her, a widow. Even if someone was, she would not be able to have a son to pass on the family name and property.
因为有路德。
But because Ruth was with her.
哦，所以拿俄米啊，哦，她能够赎回她前夫的这个产业，还为她前夫来立哦，来存留她的名啊名字下去。
Naomi was able to keep her husband's name, and pass it.Down and also the property.
哦，那再来哦，这个第四章的十五节那里。
Now let's read chapter 4, verse 15.
哦，四章的十五节，他必提起你的精神，奉养你的老，因为是爱慕你的那儿妇所生的。有这儿妇，比有七个儿子还好。哦，对拿俄米也好，甚至对路德也好，哦，因为他们哦，这个婆媳之间的。哦，这个彼此相爱，哦，信任帮助，哎，他们的都老有所终啊。
And because Ruth and Naomi loved each other, then they had security for their lives in their old age.
哎，有人来养他们的老，来照顾他们。
They were now taken care of.
哦，如果没有路德，哦，没有拿俄米，哦，他们用爱 来彼此帮助的话，这一切都不可能成就。
If they had not supported one another in love, none of this would have happened.
那最重要的一点呢
？The most important.
哦，在这个四章的十七节
，Chapter 4 verse 17。
哦，四章十七节说，邻舍的妇人说，拿俄米得的孩子，就给孩子起名叫俄贝德。这俄贝德是耶西的父，耶西是大卫的父。哦，这里说哦，啊，因着路德跟拿好、哦、跟这个波阿斯结婚哦，所生下的孩子成为大卫的父亲哦，那也就是将来弥赛亚哦，从大卫的根而出哦。神的救恩计划得以能够进行，能够完成。
And it was through because of the love of Naomi and Ruth, and then Ruth gave birth to a son that became the ancestor of David. And through the line of David, accomplished his salvation plan with the Messiah.
哦，今天我们婆媳关系如果处得好。
So if we have a good relationship between mothers and daughter-in-law,
哎，不但啊，啊，直接帮助我们的儿女。
Not only can we help our own children directly,
哦，也间接的帮助我们后代的子子孙孙。
We will also indirectly help our descendants.
哦，能够啊，啊，哦，能够为神哦来栽培将来所要使用的工人。
We will raise up workers that God can use in the future.
哦，所以我们从路德记啊。好，看到这个婆媳之间的关系是怎么建立。
So from the book of Ruth, we can learn many lessons on how to build up a relationship between mother and daughter-in-law.
在于有共同的信仰。
It starts with a common faith.
在于彼此的相爱。
And then a mutual love.
哦，愿我们主内所有的啊，这个做人婆婆的也好，做人媳妇的也好。都能够效法路德跟拿俄米。
Whether we are mother-in-law or daughter-in-law, may we learn from the example of Naomi and Ruth.
哦，来得着啊一个啊，这神所祝福的哦，这个婆媳啊。
That we may receive a good relationship.
好，我们一起来唱诗。
Let's sing hymn.
126首。
126。
请坐。
Please be seated.
好，我们现在一起来祷告。
Let us pray together.
啊，祷告的时候，我们为一些身体欠安的弟兄姐妹来祷告。
Let us pray for the brothers and sisters who are ill.
啊，我们也特别为啊，苏慧珍姐妹她的父亲，哦，嘉义教会啊，台湾嘉义教会的苏执事，哦，他在加护病房啊，我们为他祷告。
Let us also pray for sister the Melanie's father, Deacon Su in Taiwan, who is in the ICU.
哦，他是好心脏开刀哈。
He recently underwent heart surgery.
哦，那我们也继续为我们下午哦安息生日的聚会啊，求神继续带领。
Let us also pray for our afternoon service. May God continue to guide us.
哦，一起同心跪下祷告。
Let's kneel down and pray one accord.